Confidence is just an attitude that has nothing to do with whether you're able to back it up or not. In fact, quite a lot of people who show confidence are unable to back it up, and a lot of people who are qualified and should be confident are not. Verbal communication is a dead giveaway on your level of confidence, which is why today I'm going to tell you about 10 common sentences that you are using that scream about your lack of confidence and how to replace them on your daily life. Because I believe you deserve to live your life at its full potential. Number one is, I'm sorry. Truly confident people are not sorry. Or at least, they are not sorry unless they have to be sorry. People lacking confidence, on the other hand, will feel like they have to say I'm sorry every single time. They will have a feeling of inferiority. Let's make an experiment, shall we? Count the times you apologize throughout your day, and then go back to all those times and think about which time was legit. When did you actually feel sorry? And unless you're a real jerk, I'm pretty sure that it was only once or twice at worst. And most of the time, zero. So just drop it and keep it for the times where you are actually sorry. Not only it will benefit you and your confidence and how you show confidence to others, but it will also greatly benefit in your apologies. If you show to the world that you're sorry for everything, when you will truly be sorry, that will not make any difference to anyone. Number two is, I think. When someone is asking you something, they already know that you think the answer. Otherwise, you wouldn't give this answer to them. By saying I think, you reduce the impact of what you're saying by changing it from a fact to an opinion. If really you do need and desire to give a true opinion, then change I think with I believe. Because I believe shows stronger confidence in what you want to say rather than thinking, which is something a bit more volatile. A thought is something that comes and goes. It can be changed pretty easily. However, a belief is something that is strongly and deeply rooted in your mind. Number three, I'm worried. This is a confidence killer. Only people who lack confidence worry. Worrying is about the problem. If you worry, that means that you're scared we will have a problem. And that's pretty much it. Instead of being worried, feel concerned about the subject. Because when you're concerned about something, that means that you're searching for a solution. So during a discussion with your boss or with your friends or colleagues or pretty much anyone, when you're talking about a problem, say that you are concerned about this problem and so that you need to find a solution, rather than being worried about this problem and just showing that you're scared of the negative impact of it. Number four, if it's okay, would you mind? Or what I call the double door. The less opportunities you give to others to reply to what you're asking for by the negative, and the more power you keep. And by keeping this power, you appear more confident. By saying, if it's okay for you, would you mind? You give two opportunities to the person in front of yourself to say no. Because if it's okay for you, no, it's not okay for me. Would you mind? Yes, I would mind. Don't give this power to others. Show that you're here and that you need them to do something. For that, replace the if by when. If you have a minute, would you mind doing this? When you have a minute, would you mind doing this? It's just one word. But in one case, you give them the opportunity to say no. In the other one, you just tell them to do it when they are able to do so. And if the situation allows it, also change the would you mind by please do it. It is as polite as the first one, even more polite than the first one. But in one case, you give them two opportunities to close the door in front of your nose, while in the other, you don't let them a single chance to do it. When you have a minute, please do this. Number 5. I hate to bother you, but I hate to disrupt you, but those are pretty close to the I'm sorry and are as useless as this I'm sorry. If you are going to someone to ask them to do something or to explain you something, it means that it's important for you. Just like for the previous sentence, by doing so, you give up your power by saying, I hate bothering you, I know I'm bothering you, I know that I'm making this situation uncomfortable, so please take control of it and tell me if that's okay. It is okay. You need it. You have to bother this person, knowing that most of the time it will not bother this person to help you, because this will help you grow. So don't hate bothering. Don't be scared of bothering. Just go to this person and say, when you have a minute, I need your help. Number 6, just. This word has literally no other meaning but reducing the importance of what you're asking for or doing. I just need a minute. I'm sending you this email just to tell you. No, you're sending an email to tell them about something. You need a minute to talk about something. You don't just need it. This word serves no other purpose than reducing the importance of what you actually need or do. And this one is not only true about email or conversation. No, this one is also true about your actual life. You are not just yourself. You are yourself. You are amazing as who you are. Not just who you are, but who you truly are. And on this note, I'm going to number 7, which is all the kind of, sort of. And just like just, those words are useless. Tell me a single situation where kind of has given any kind of information. Never. When you have to explain something to someone, don't say it's kind of or sort of something else, because it just shows that you are unsure. You don't master the subject, / you're not confident enough in what you know, in what you're saying, to be able to be precise. It is more difficult. It is longer than. It is shorter than. It is harder than. Use adjectives that will explain the situation, not just some vague expressions that will kinda show what you want to say, but not really. Now to number 8. Hopefully. This word is something that you should just remove from your vocabulary. Hopefully shows that you are absolutely not confident, to the point that you're putting hope in it, meaning that you're putting exterior sources into what you're saying. It doesn't even depend on yourself anymore. It depends on the alignment of the stars. It's not because a superior force will come to help you that it will work. It will work because you will work for it and that you will master it and nail it. So remove this hopefully from your vocabulary if you want to look confident. Number 9, those are not words or expressions, but more question tags. We usually tend to say, haven't you? Could you? This movie was great, wasn't it? At the end of a sentence. To ask a question, but also to soften our opinion and to ask for basically the approval of others. By doing so, you are subconsciously invalidating your opinions, your thoughts. You are trying to search for the approval of others and show a lack of confidence in what you truly believe. You enjoyed this movie. Then this movie is great. I believe this movie was great. What did you think about it? In this case, you are truly and genuinely asking the opinion of the other person. And this doesn't show that you lack confidence. It shows that you're interested in their opinion. But saying, "This movie was great, wasn't it?" You're asking them to comfort yourself by saying that this movie was great. And if they tell you that they didn't like it, you will feel that your opinion is not legitimate. And finally, one of the worst confidence-killing word: I'll try. Of course, confident people do try, but they don't simply try. They aim to succeed. When you say, "I try," you already go backwards. You already tell people that you're not here to succeed. You're just here to try. And yes, I'm using just in this situation because you are just trying, not aiming for success. Show that you have confidence in your ability to succeed. Don't try, do. And by doing so, you will start to live your life at its full potential. And this is the end of 10 common sentences that show your lack of confidence. I hope you liked the video. If you did, don't forget to put a thumbs up, share the video, subscribe to my channel. If you're interested in those videos, please click on the channel's page notification bell. This will greatly help me. And no matter what happens, I will see you in my next video. Have an amazing, wonderful day. Don't forget to smile and live your life at its full potential.